Wheeler's got it.
Here with the tools and just TIC and look it over, make sure everything's.
Wayne asked me if we're copying that. Shook my head. Alright. Wheeler up there, let's check it out. Yeah, I don't think that roof would hold any of it. Still smell it. I'd say we've still got something somewhere. Yeah, move it slow because we got a lot of weight up here. It's going to bounce pretty easy. There's still sparks and embers flying from up here from that restaurant. There's still sparks flying up here from those brush piles. We get this taken care of. We can go ahead and wet it down good, but we may still end up coming back. Open up your side. That's the pull lever down below. Is yours the one that's plumbed into the sprinkler? Yeah. There you go. Okay. Now just start moving around with that. Kind of move back and forth. You're actually spraying water now, so you can move side to side. You just can't move in and out. Or you can move out and not back in. And over here to your left, I can see still going. So, okay, hold that. Take the nozzle over on Chris's side, and he can hit that over there that's still smoldering. Yeah, we've got the sprinkler on underneath. Go ahead and open that up and wet everything down really good. Wet down the fire area, but then make sure we get everything else good and wet too, because there's still sparks. Without a doubt, we'll be back up here. I don't think we have a fire issue anymore. We're going to go ahead and wet everything down real good though.
Then you can open your drain to come on down.
Okay, copy that. They're going to shut our water down. Just go ahead and leave that open, and that'll help. Just leave it wide open. There you go. And we'll leave the sprinkler open. Chris, on your side, there's a little black plug down here that you pull, and it's a little drain spout.
You see the black plug right here on the side?
At the bottom of this 5-inch line, there's a little drain spout. Okay, pull that pin, and it'll let that drain. Okay, and then they're going to open up the waterway down there, and then we should be able to start to retract. They'll let us know. Okay, we've got everything open up here, 421. Whenever you've got the waterway open, we'll start coming back.
Okay, just stay there for just a minute.
Copy that.
421, I got a shutdown.
Heck of a view, huh?
Go up.
Yep.
Yeah. We got it all, but I really highly doubt we're done because we still got embers and ashes stuff floating up here, and all this, that's highly, highly flammable, that old chipboard. It's not when it's new, but when it's old like this and all the sealants and glues are wore out of it, man, it's just tender.
This used to be a rubber roof.
Yeah. Well, didn't it have like a foam, like a 2-inch piece of foam all the way across it and then rubber on top of that? I think
he's
talking to Dave. Yeah, he's got to break the lines loose for relief pressure. I'd go ahead and go more or less straight up, and what that does is it just helps the water to drain. As long as we're not near any power lines and we're clear.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure we'll be back. I mean, I'd be surprised if we weren't. Well, that's not the first time it's burned, because you notice it's got other burn spots up there that put themselves out. Okay. Oh, from me,
I'm waiting on you.
Later. Buddy, thank you, man. holding air and water. Should be in here. Alright guys, that'll do it.
I'm all over here, Wayne.
Got two. That's it. Just walking over there?
Yeah.
Man. We need some rain.